Hey, what's going on, gamers? Thank you for joining me as always. Today's video, we're talking about the most expensive, shiny, fancy, interesting weapon or item in TF2, and that is the Golden Pan. As kind of cliche as it is to have one or to see one, to a lot of players, it's still a big deal, and it's always fun to see their eyes light up in game and screenshot me and ask me to drop it and follow me around the map, and the other team focuses me all over to try to kill me and steal my pan. It's just one of those fun, unique things about TF2.
Golden Pan?
No.
Bro. Golden Pan. Yes, you. You got a Golden Pan. Yes. Yes.
Cheers, man.
Gimme. Kill yourself now. Gimme. Gimme. Hey, guys, you see this pan? A Golden Pan.
Squirrely, can you be my new dad?
The question I've been getting asked a lot since I got one, and people see it more often, is did you trade for it, and should I trade for one, should I save up, should I spend money on it, should I play MVM for it? Basically, what is the best way, what is the smartest way if you really wanted to get a Golden Pan? So in this video, we're going to explore that. I'm going to break it down, I'm going to do the math, that way it'll kind of put things more in perspective and let you make a more educated decision for yourself. I'm sure a lot of you already have the answer in your head of what you think, but I'm going to show you and give you a real-world example of some MVM players who have played a lot and really break it down. Okay, what are your chances of getting a Golden Pan, and what are your chances of getting an Australium? Because it's two very different things. So what I did is I found an MVM player who had a lot of tours, and I think this person's top 5, top 3, 4, 5, somewhere around there, and just kind of did the math of how many times have they played, how many Australiums do they have, how many Golden Pans do they have, just to kind of give you some stats on exactly what are the odds if you were to play over 1,000 tours of MVM of actually winning a Golden Pan. So let's go to this player's profile. They did a really nice job. Thanks to them for actually listing every single tour they won in Australium. It breaks it down. You can look through this entire thing of what tour, what they got, how many they played total. So it's really easy to do the math. So I'll go through it with you guys right now. So for the MVM Mecha maps, it's three maps, so there's three tour duty tickets, which is a dollar each about, roughly. And he played 151 tours, and he got 7 Australiums. So do the math, that's about every 21.5 tours, he got an Australium. If you times that by 3 for $3 each, every about $65 on average, he got one Australium. For 151 tours times $3, he paid $453 for 7 Australiums. Now, definitely lost money, $450. You could have bought all these, you know, Australiums multiple times. So the next one on the list is two cities, and he played 534 tours, which is 4 maps times 4 tour duty tickets, and he ended up getting 18 Australiums. If you do the math for this, you can say that he got an Australium about every 30 tours. If you divide that by how much it costs, about $120 per Australium, and he got 18 Australiums. He spent over $2,131 on these 534 tours. So for the last one was Expert, and he ended up playing over 1,049 tours, and he got 31 Australiums out of that. So not a whole lot, even for doing 1,000 tours. Not a great as far as price range, but he did get 31 Australiums, but it ended up costing him well over $3,000, $3,147, which breaks down to about $101, $102 per Australium. So unless you're getting, you know, well over $100 for each Australium that you win, you're losing money. Now you're starting to see the math exactly how much it costs to play MVM if you're trying to get in Golden Pan or even just make profit in general. So bringing this all together, wrapping it up, this guy's grand total, he played 1,734 tours of MVM, which costed him $5,736. Some of that were, you know, were 3 maps, some of them were 4 maps for Expert and 2 cities, but overall he spent close to $6,000 on MVM. Now, I'm not saying this to bash the guy or make fun of him. I'm totally not for that, right? Everyone can spend their money and their hobbies and their time however they want. That's cool, and I think MVM is actually a lot of fun. But mathematically, he could almost buy 2 Golden Pans for the price of playing for this many tours. I mean, you can get a decent Golden Pan for $3,000 and have almost, you know, what is that, $2,700 left over. So there's the math right there. If you look at how many Australiums he actually won out of 1,734 tours, he got 56 Australiums, which is 3.2%. Meaning, even if he got the most expensive Australium every single time, he's getting like Islander, you know, rocket launcher, professional kits, like the best thing every single time he wins, he still loses massively. It's almost impossible to be profitable when you play MVM. unless you get lucky and within a certain amount of tours, a couple hundred, you just hit it rich with a golden pan. Or you play like, you know, 20 tours, you get an Aussy rocket launcher or a really, really nice professional kit. Like, other than that, the more tours you play, the nicer things you have to win, which just becomes counterproductive. This whole time I've been talking about the drop rate for Australiums, which the most expensive Australium is obviously the golden pan, which I haven't even talked about yet because that is even lower, much, much, much lower than 3.2% according to this guy's case study of how many Australiums he won in his 1700 tours. So for the golden pan, I've heard everything from 0.00001%, which I think is too low. Otherwise, it would almost never happen. More realistically, I think it's somewhere between 0.39, you know, a little under 0.5% I've seen, to 0.005. So anywhere between there, who knows? Well, so there you guys have it. I did a little case study. I ran the numbers and showed you guys exactly if you were to spend the time and play over 1,700 tours of MVM, how many Australiums would you get? Would you have a chance of getting a golden pan? Would you get anything nice? Would you make any profit? And basically, no. It's much smarter. It's much safer to just trade up to a golden pan or spend some money or do whatever you got to do to make it work, because if you're actually going to run the numbers and play, I think the number one guy actually has over 3,000 tours, but he actually has a golden pan. But he traded for it. So he didn't earn it himself either. So that's what I did. I figured, you know what? It's way smarter. It's way cheaper. It's way faster to just trade up to a golden pan than to play 10,000 tours and there's still no guarantee I get one. So, of course, it'd be more fun to play MVM. And it's much more exciting to unbox an unusual or, you know, have a golden pan drop and have that nice, fresh thing. But it's complete luck, 100% luck. You're talking about one in who knows how many thousand chance of getting one. So you can either earn a golden pan the hard way and play MVM and play for your whole life and never get one, or you could just save up and buy one. Either way works. So, all right, you guys, thanks for joining me as always. I hope to see you in game, and I will show you my golden pan. And if you kill me, you can pick it up and taunt me with it and all that good stuff. So then you got a golden pan for free. You didn't even have to trade for one or buy one. How lucky are you? All right, you guys, have a good one. Until next time, peace.
Disney rides, like the like, you know how Pirates of the Caribbean was just like some Disney ride, and it just sort of you're just sort of like there, and you kind of like see stuff happen, experience it. That was epic, by the way.